Tobago. Welcome to the Bonacord Recreation Ground in to Love the Island of Tobago. We are here today to bring you coverage of the Super League encounter between Police FC and Tobago 1976 FC. But there is much more to this evening. It's more or less a celebration and to highlight what this team has achieved so far. I have with me Michael Hitchcock, the head of Playbook Management
International,
a sports organization that has partnered with this Tobago outfit. And Mike, it's always a pleasure to chat with you. Welcome to Tobago again.
Thank you. It's wonderful to be back in paradise.
Now, tell us about this evening. The team will be wearing a commemorative jersey to mark the carnival. I think it's the first time a football team or any sporting organization has done that. How did the idea come about?
So I was here 4 weeks ago and listening to some incredible steel pan music and hearing about the excitement that everyone had, not just for the Christmas holiday, but for Carnival following that. And it's like the light bulb went on and thought, why not create a custom commemorative Carnival kit to celebrate not just the end of a very, very successful season for Tobago FC Phoenix, but also knowing everyone's going to be in the spirit of Carnival, using it as a kickoff to the Carnival party season. So opportunity to not just have a football match here for the community, but also have a celebration of music and drink and food and family and friends and wear a commemorative kit.
You all are actually giving back something to the community.
Yeah, I mean, football's a game of the people for the people, and I feel a professional club has an obligation to give back to the community. And so for us, today's a very special day because I think it shows the incredible potential that exists when a club and the community come together to not just celebrate the beautiful game, but also something that's important to the community.
Now, this year has to be Phoenix's most successful year. They are currently third in the standings. As a partner to this football team, how are you feeling right now? And your other team is doing very well too. I think they came off a 2-1 victory recently. So both teams are up there. How your organization is handling this and what can we expect from both teams?
Yeah, our team in England's on a 7-game unbeaten streak. So we have not lost in 2016 in the National League in UK. So very proud of the effort there. And just as proud of Tobago FC Phoenix and the season that the team has had. The players have really come together under the leadership of Terry and I think have really rallied to represent the island and to show that football in Tobago is as good, if not better, than many of the clubs in Trinidad. And so we're very proud of where the team is. And I think it's something that is really just a starting point for what we're trying to accomplish. And, you know, there's going to be tremendous opportunities for footballers in Tobago and taking players to England for an opportunity to play for our club there. And also in the U.S. And so we're excited. This just shows the, I believe, incredible potential that exists. And it's a combination of you know, city and community leadership with you know, great leadership in a passionate person like Terry Williams, and then just being able to provide some professional infrastructure and investment.
Well, Mike, I want to thank you very much. I know we're going to keep in touch. We expect great things from both the teams that you all have invested in, more so from Tobago, because Phoenix has been performing. I mean, they have some little hiccups here and there, but the team has improved. And I think with the partnership that you all have given to this team, it has done something for this team.
Well, I appreciate your support and thank you for coming out and joining us.
Welcome.
Yeah, thanks.
The game, and that's the start of this game here. And I can tell you that Police, no walkover team. On the other hand, Phoenix FC should be high on confidence because they just came off a spectacular victory over Gwaya United. Grimshaw sends it wide. Inside too, that's Raymond. Raymond goes down the wing, but his cross still, and it's on Frank should have done, and a shot comes in, and again, we see a shot coming in there from Melvin, but high and wide, but Frank should have done a little bit better there, should have taken that that early shot there, but nevertheless, some good attacking play by Phoenix FC. A lot of the spectators anxious here in support of their team Phoenix. It's going to be a free kick to the Police. It's a free kick or a throw-in. It's going to be a throw-in to be taken by, that's Archie. In comes what? The official on the far side flag is up, so there seems to be some infringement. So it's going to be, we are happy to see Jack Haas, the owner of the printing company that supplied these jerseys for the Phoenix team, and also Michael Hitchcock, the president of Playbook Management International, the sporting company that has partnered with Phoenix. Phoenix definitely much improved team this year, 2015 going into 2016. And the ball comes into the defense, and it's by that's Frank. Frank turns, goes inside. Melvin got cleared out there only as far as Melvin. Melvin heads it, but Frank is in a chase there with Peters, and Peters gives away a throwing. So Akil Frank with a good opportunity and a cleared by Didier. Ned and Woodrum in a tussle. It's back with Phoenix inside. Not being handled properly there is Shelton Williams. So it's a bit of a scramble so far, scrappy. A bit of scrappiness. Both teams haven't really settled as yet. And we expect as the minutes go on, both teams will settle. The playing surface is not ideal, so these guys will have to adapt very soon. Samson. Archie trying to get Morris. Morris has once, but sends it back to Peters. Peters sends it, yes, but an opportunity. And well, Ned Clarence didn't go as he expected, and definitely create some anxious moment there for Samson in goal for Phoenix. So it's back with Phoenix. That's Akil Frank. Frank inside to that's Leandro Williams. A little slip of the tongue there, but it's back headed on there by Melvin. It's with the number six for Police. That's Archie. And the ball comes off of Melvin, and it's going to be just inside the Phoenix half of the field. In comes it straight inside the 18-yard box. The head goes up, but good defending. A shot coming in there from that's Harris, but it goes for and Police, but good again, good defending. Well, we saw some horrendous defending from Phoenix in that game against Defense Force, and really only themselves to blame for not walking away with the points in that game. So it's going to be this time a free kick. So Police and it comes off. It appears, yes, it comes off the, I think it was Leandro Williams, and it's going to be a corner to Police. So in comes the corner. Look at number 25, that's Morris, but Morris not in proper control of the ball, and it goes way over the bar. No problems whatsoever for Samson. So it's back with Melvin. Kill on Melvin. That ball definitely too strong for Williams, and it goes aimlessly just into over 10 minutes gone. Still goalless here at the Bonaccord Recreation Ground in this Super League encounter. And as you heard earlier in the interview from Mike Hitchcock, it's a day of celebration here for Phoenix, giving back to the community, wearing this attractive uniform for the first time to mark the kind of a celebration. And no whistle, but I think that was a 50-50. A pretty decent crowd, I would say, here at the Bonacord Ground. I might be chastised if I go as far as saying a lot more people here than what we see in a Pro League game. Back with the action, that's Bodhram, skipper Bodhram, inside to Williams. And no problem there for Samson. It's actually a throw, you know. That's Melvin. Keegan Melville. He's going to take a long throw. Nine. A poor cross. I call it poor clearance. Back to Melvin. Melvin sends it across, looking, Shelton Williams is called for the infringement on, therefore, police. Morris looking to get Williams. Williams, what? Definitely, we are seeing a much improve, and this young guy has some speed, that's Frank. As I was saying, much improved performance from that game, where actually they handed Defense Force 3 very soft goals. I am sure that they ruined that game because they would have been in second position. They are currently on 49 points. I don't think any of the other teams can catch Phoenix for third place at present. So they are in line for, I think the third place team at the end of the competition receives 100,000. So they are in line for some good cash once they can maintain that third position. It's going to be a free kick. A nice true ball there for Melvin. Can he keep it in play? The ground, as you see, the ball keeps bouncing. And that's Frank. Frank not being able to. Well, Frank has switched sides, actually. He's now on the left side. And the ball comes in again. And Harris had all the time in the world. And it's going to be the first card. And referee is going to give the first card of the game to, that's Simon Ned for the, and a deflection, and it's going to be a corner. So young Frank, very a good throwing so far.
Yes.
Inside to Thomas turns. What? Thomas is infringed from behind. There was some contact. There was some contact there from Didier. A great position here for, I think, Andel Brung, but I don't think it's Andel Brung this time. In comes the shot, and what a shot! What a great shot there coming from Melvin and goalkeeper Adisa. So actually 2 minutes gone, referee looking at his clock. And that signals the end of the first half. a first half with not much opportunities from either teams. The best opportunity coming on the stroke of 45 minutes from that free kick from Shelton Williams. First of all, before we talk anything else, I'm going to ask them, how do you like Tobago? How have you been enjoying yourself?
It's paradise. I got here Friday and I don't want to leave. So it's fantastic. I love the people. Very friendly.
Okay. Well, you are the owner of
Unitas.
Unitas, the
uniform
yes. company that has done the uniforms here for Phoenix FC.
Yes.
How did the design and, I mean, I'm sure you didn't know anything about Carnival. So
correct.
How did everything come together.
Michael Hitchcock called me at 10 o'clock on a Friday night and said, we'd like to do something completely different that's mm-hmm. never been done before. I'll send you some ideas. So he emailed me photos of Carnival and steel drums mm-hmm. and the people celebrating mm-hmm. and said, go to town, find something creative. Mm-hmm. And together over 2 weeks, we designed it with the artists mm-hmm. and produced them. So yeah.
Are you a football fan?
A huge football fan, yes.
So it didn't take much in you,
no.
you know, getting involved.
Exactly.
What has captured your eyes, you know, since coming to Tobago?
The people.
Yeah.
The people here are different than anywhere. I've been all over the world, and they're just different. Their mm-hmm. passion for life and football is amazing. Mm-hmm. It's very, very contagious.
So we expect to see you, if not for this carnival, for somewhere down the line, or maybe for a great football game.
Count on it. I'll be back.
Thank you very much, and
Thank
enjoy
you.
Your stay.
Nice to meet you. Thank you.
Welcome back to the Bonacore Recreation Ground, and that's the start of the second half in this encounter between Police FC and Phoenix 1976 FC at the end of the first half. Both teams unable to break the deadlock. So we might have so headed down there by that's Didier back straight into the barrow with the free kick and not good defending there. The two players who were in the wall and a bit of scrappiness creeping in here in the Phoenix play. Elliot sends back to Didier. Didier sends it on the near side here to Morris. Morris takes it long. Goes past nicely there, and the head goes up. And a brilliant save there by goalkeeper Samson. In comes, floats across, and up comes, and a shot coming in from Peters, but goes over the bar in Tobago. A true ball there, Leandro, a good run here, comes across the force of the goal, and it's a beautiful goal! A beautiful goal by Thomas. Nigel Thomas, with just 6 minutes. Yeah. 6 minutes of football in the second half, and giving them that goal, and can they hold on with the extent is left to be seen. Still sufficient time here in this game with just 6 or 7 minutes gone here. So, but a great header there from young Thomas, and it's a break here, and so that's Thomas, Richards goes past one, looks up, still confronted by two players, and so Archie has in comes the shot, took a deflection, and it's going to be a corner. And some anxious moments. So that's Andel Brown goes on a run down the left side. Has one, turns inside to Frank. Frank possesses right foot, goes inside. That's Shelton Williams, a big, strong Shelton Williams, but it's broken up and it's back with Morris for police, please. And it's Frank again being confronted here. And a strong tackle again. So the police players are definitely a bit of heavy-handed tacklers coming in there from Police FC. It's Police, and I don't think there is no way that Grimshaw is going to allow good tight screen in there by Grimshaw. So it's back with Phoenix. Paris. Ball a bit too strong. It's back with that's Melvin. Melvin goes past one, sends it downfield. Good true pass there for that's Richard Cheer. Richards, one of the players who I saw for the first time in the, and a shot coming in, but a lot of power, but not directed. Um, 69 minutes have gone here in this game. And an opportunity here. It's a break here. And let's see. Maybe taking a bit too long. And the pass. What a good. That's a wrong shot. But it was a good opportunity there. But I think the player took a little bit too long before crossing that ball. And when he did, it was a bit too strong. But a good opportunity there again for Phoenix back here, and we are seeing some pulling of the Phoenix, and it's inside, but a bit too strong, and it's an opportunity, and it's goal number two. That's Leandro Williams. So goal number two. So Leandro Williams put in the second goal. So some breathing space here for Phoenix. So Police now under the gun. No fun intended, but so it's going to be a celebration here at the end of this game, I'm sure. Once, and a strong tackle there again, and there is a player for and sitting pretty well with this two-goal advantage over Police. So back-to-back victories here for Phoenix, having defeated Gwaya United on Thursday. Now that's a couple of days coming back home, and definitely going to be walking away with the 3 points here, and will maintain their third place. And it's an opportunity here for Richard. Richard has, and the shot comes in, but Allen, goalkeeper Adisa Allen, equal to the task. Phoenix FC of Tobago and Police. Cleared out avoiding any danger. The supporters now for Phoenix really not being able to keep that ball in play. That's number 24, that's Harris. Good skill. That's Figueroa. But good defending in the midfield there by Phoenix. A true ball there, and it's a chase between that's Peters and and an opportunity here. An opportunity and a great save by goalkeeper Addison Allen. Certainly that was heading to be goal number three, but a great save there. And Allen seemed to have damaged himself, but still not out of danger. And it's and Allen again calling to make a timely save. Great goalkeeping there by Addison Allen. Addison Allen has a lot of experience. Once was a member of the police pro league team, has lost his place to Adrian Fonset, now saving for the Super League team. Police with an opportunity here, but a good defending by Phoenix. And then Brung. And it's an opportunity here for goal number three. And how lucky can Phoenix, unlucky be, can Phoenix get a great opportunity? And Phoenix turning the pressure on here in the last couple of minutes here. Players. And referee still looking at his clock, his watch. Still a man down, still looking at his clock. There is referee Wallace. And that's the final whistle indicating the end of this game. Phoenix FC coming away with impressive victory in front of their home crowd, 2-0. And we will be having a chat with Andel Brung, the skipper. Joining me here is the captain of Phoenix FC. First of all, congratulations on a well-deserved victory here this afternoon.
Yes, thank you very much.
Let's go back into the game. From my observation, when the game started, as I was mentioning, I wasn't seeing Andel Brung too much in the game, you know, but gradually you came and you led from the front. Now, a better second half from my judgment.
Yes.
Now, what is it like now for Phoenix? This is one of your better years in the Super League. I mean, currently third, and now with PMI being instrumental in partnering with you all. What is that doing for the team presently?
Well, presently, doing for the team, well, all the guys are motivated because we have a great sponsor come on board. Mm. And guys are looking forward. As you know, we have partnership with clubs in Texas and England. So the guys are really highly motivated because you have opportunity for the players, young players. Mm-hmm. Also maybe middle-aged guys to go out and get opportunity to maybe get contracts and go to bigger teams.
How long have you been a member of this team?
Since about 6 years. 6 years. 6 years old.
Yeah. Now, I think you'll have about two or three games remaining, you know. One more game remaining against Wasa. That's a home game?
That's an away game.
Currently, nobody all could catch you all at third position,
no. Right?
But you are still going to go out there and play good football. What can we expect from Phoenix in that final game?
Well, in our final game, we'll go all out because we want to see if we can catch Kwaya and maybe came second. And the guys are really, really motivated from this win against Police. So we're going really hard, last game of the season against Wasa, to finish the season strong.
Well, Allel, congratulations. All the best. I will look forward to another 3 points against Wasa.
Yes. Yeah, thank you very much. And we'll look forward for that game.